Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's Kane, and for today's video, I will be just sharing with you some of my knowledge na nakuha ko mula sa experience ko when I took my online NMAT exam. I will be sharing some tips that I think would help you, especially if you have really short time of preparation, kasi that's what I experienced. If you wanna cram, or if you have to cram about NMAT, or maybe just know stuff about online NMAT and taking the NMAT itself, just keep on watching. So I will be starting off by giving you some brief introduction about NMAT. So NMAT is basically National Medical Admission Test, designed to measure the abilities of medical student aspirants in the Philippines, the abilities that are deemed useful for selection purposes in the medical schools. Kapag nag-take kayo ng NMAT, meron siyang dalawang part. First one is the aptitude, and the second one is the special area. Part 1, meron siyang apat na sub-test: verbal, inductive reasoning, quantitative, and perceptual acuity. The second one naman, yun yung mas specialized sa subjects: biology, physics, chemistry, and social science. So yung scores nyo per subtest, tawag sa kanya is standard score. Graded siya as 200 to 800. Yung 800 yung pinakamataas. Ngayon, yung NMAT GPS mo, it corresponds to a PR, or a percentile rank score. It ranges from 1 to 99 plus. Yung ibig sabihin lang nun, it is the percentage of NMAT examinees na merong score na same sa'yo or mas mababa sa'yo. For example, you got 95. Your score belongs to the top 95% nung nag-take ng NMAT exam. Tapos yung PR, yun yung mismong ma-evaluate against sa cut-off na sinet ng SHED or ng medical school na pag-a-applyan mo. Isa yun na criteria na pwede magsabi kung qualified ka or not to be an applicant to that medical school. So yeah, enough with the introduction and all. Let's proceed to the tips, because this is what this video is all about. So first, make sure to make a flexible schedule and try your best to follow it. Making a flexible schedule is a really, really big help, and with try your best to follow it, I mean, kahit gaano pa karami yung kailangan mo aralin, if tapos na yung time na nilaan mo for that certain subject, then stop na kahit hindi mo pa tapos sila aralin lahat. So I guess it is better if you would move on na sa ibang section na kailangan mo rin pag-aralan, kasi just like what I mentioned earlier, ang NMAT hindi lang siya isang subject. Marami siyang mga sub-tests na kailangan mo i-ace. Actually, dun sa personal schedule ko, yung mga pinaka-importanting topics na sa tingin ko mapapasama talaga sa exam, yun yung nilagay ko dun sa first days ng preparation ko. Actually, I just prepared for like 4 days. Ganun. Tapos inuna ko yung mga part na sa tingin ko eh kailangan kong bigyan ng pansin. Tapos sa huli na lang yung mga feeling ko, pwede kong scan na lang, ganyan. Next is, you have to register early and choose your preferred slot. Mas maganda if mas maaga kayong mag-register, kasi limited lang yung slot per day. So if kayo yung mauna, para siyang first come, first serve actually. Magpasa rin kayo ng mga requirements on time, pwede pang maging nullified yung slot if na-late kayo ng pagpas ng mga requirements. Third tip is, you have to gather some review materials and even join groups with other NMAT takers. Marami actually across the net. You can ask from your friends. Pwede rin kayong ma-find ng mga trial exams, ng mga mock exams. Ayun, mag-practice kayo. Sobrang important ng testmanship when it comes to taking the NMAT. So try to build and incorporate some techniques and strategies na pwede niyong makuha from practicing, especially sa part ng perceptual acuity at saka ng inductive reasoning. Tapos ayun, since limited nga lang yung time na pwede kayong magsagot, good thing if for example mag-answer kayo ng mock exams, i-time nyo na rin yung sarili nyo para makita nyo kung paano kayo mag-perform and assess yourself so that you know where to improve pa. Personally, di na ako nag-enroll sa mga review centers kasi parang ayoko na gumastos. But if you want, actually, maganda rin yun kasi you can make yourself accountable. Marami ring materials pa. Plus, joining groups like Facebook, Discord groups, Telegram with your fellow NMAT takers could actually be a very big help, kasi aside from being updated, nagbibigay rin sila, nag-share din sila ng mga available na NMAT review materials. Tapos, pwede kayo magkaroon ng mga study group. So number 4, it's really important, make sure to navigate through the website or the exam site. Super important na i-familiarize yung sarili nyo dun sa website, especially for not so techie people like me. Like nung una ko nakita yung website, nung nagpa-practice pa lang ako, na-alienate ako kasi may mga complex stuff and mayroon siya i-navigate, I think. Tapos kapag nag-register kayo, merong handout na i-upload dun sa website na yon. And make sure na basahin nyo yun kasi it's really helpful. It's about NMAT, about the site itself, and how to navigate it. Meron din dong mga frequently asked questions. So yeah, make sure to read everything from the first page to the last. Yung trial run dun sa mismong site, it also helps. So make sure na iti-take nyo yun para ma-anticipate nyo agad kung ano man yung problem na pwede nyong ma-encounter and mapigyan nyo agad sila ng solusyon. So next part, during the exam, make sure na mag-follow kayo ng instructions. Keep your area free of any device. Dapat nakikita kayo clearly nung PASI. One thing that I learned and I kinda didn't like about the exam is it tends to be really strict. I mean, I don't mean it in a bad way. I know the PASIs are just doing their job and of course it's their responsibility then. But a lot of things can get misinterpreted, so it's better to be safe talaga. I was flagged a lot of times. So one reason is that sobrang lapit sa screen, di daw makita yung eyes ko sa camera. So yeah, lamo lumayo. Tapos meron din one time, nag-a-answer ako ng math. So of course, naturally, I was solving on my scratch, which is yun yung whiteboard. Tapos na-flag ulit ako kasi hindi ako nakatingin sa camera. Anyways, you can message naman your PASI every now and then. Like, you can explain. In the middle of taking the exam din, bigla kayo ipapa-room tour. Hindi ko alam kung sa lahat to, pero ako, pina-room tour ako. Room tour? Kasi titignan talaga lahat. I-instruct kayo na ipakita yung buong room nyo para masigurado na walang any device na pwede gamitin sa pag-cheat. Next is always be mindful of all the stuff that you're clicking kasi, for example, one wrong click can accidentally exit the exam. At yung one of my biggest fear before, kasi nung nagpa-practice ako ng exam, in the next section ko lang, tapos na-exit ko siya lahat. Kapag na-exit mo siya accidentally, hindi mo na siya pwede erase. Yung exam, diba, like, per subtest, section-section siya. Tapos nakakalito yung kailangan mo pindutin after every section. So, you might accidentally exit the exam. Kahit yung gusto mo lang naman gawin is lumipat sa sunod na section or sa sunod na subtest. Next is, skip the things that you don't know about because it could actually rob you of your time. So, yun, with NMAT, especially kapag hindi ka masyado nakapag-prepare, lalo yung verbal part, things can be really difficult. And ako mahina talaga sa English personally and sa vocab. So, one thing I do is just, I answer whatever. Kung ano yung hunch ko na feeling ko ito sagot, sagot ko na lang agad. Kasi diba, kung pag-iisipan ko naman yung mabuti, makukuha lang yung oras ko na pwede ko pang ispend dun sa mga mas worth it na item. Sadly, this is also one of my mistakes. Kasi meron pa rin akong mga oras na nasayang sa certain items. Tapos di ko natapos yung last part. Eh yung last part, perceptual acuity. So yun yung mga find the different image, which is relatively nasa easier side siya. Another thing is be mindful of time. Since it is online nga, pag sinabing 20 minutes lang yung ganitong subtest, then 20 minutes lang talaga siya natapos naman or hindi. Kung siya na siya magsasubmit, try nyo divide yung oras if you can para alam nyo kung kailan nyo na dapat magmadali or kung kailan kayo dapat, alam nyo yun, like slowly but surely lang. Just so, finally, after the exam, one, whether you finished the previous section or not, or if you are still caught up in some items, pero tapos na yung time, then kailangan nyo na talaga mag-move on and mag-move forward to the next one. You have to focus on what is front of you. At isipin nyo na rin siguro na maraming ang part yung exam. So if kinulang kayo dun sa isang part, then bawiin nyo na lang dun sa kabila. To add to that, this is actually my mantra na rin. Kaya when I was preparing for NMAT, since sobrang kulang na nga yung time for me, mas nag-focus ako dun sa mga subjects that I think I could do well, like the quantitative, biology, at saka soksay. Yung tatlong yun talaga yung pinokus ko. Well, aside from the perceptual acuity and the inductive reasoning na actually makukuha mo siya sa practice, focus ako dun sa tatlo. Kasi if aralan ko siya, kahit konting oras lang, alam kong may makukuha at makukuha ako. Pero yung mga weakness ko, like yung chemistry at saka yung physics, if aaralan ko siya sa loob ng isa o dalawang araw lang, like let's be honest, wala namang mareretain. So ba't ako magsasayang ng oras yun? Like literally, inalay ko na lang talaga siya. Yung inasa ko na lang dun sa mga keywords. So ayun, yung physics and chemistry talaga, like literally alay, kasi yun yung weakness point ko. And within the span of time na meron ako to prepare, I know na kahit gawin ko yung best ko para isiksik yung mga ganong ka-complex and ka-broad na concepts, for me, ma-overwhelm na ako, tapos wala akong mare-retain. So masasayang lang yung time, And I'd rather spend that time practicing math problems, reading through familiar biology concepts, oksa na kailangan lang i-refresh sa utak. Of course, practicing inductive reasoning problems and perceptual acuity, learning strategies, learning techniques. Mas nag-focus ako doon. This is just my personal opinion. Just do what works for you. Yung iba, mas preferred nilang mag-focus kung saan sila mas nahihirapan, tapos mas winiwing na lang nila kung saan sila mas nadadalian. And actually, that is also smart. So, if that works on you, then just do that. Second is use your break wisely. Actually, after, I think, the first part, bigyan kayo ng 10-minute break. You can go to the restroom, you can grab some snacks. Make sure na magpapaalam kayo sa FASI kasi baka mamaya misinterpret yung pag-alis nyo or anything like that. Tapos lastly, after the exam, kapag natapos mo na siya, isubmit mo na siya. Don't be hard on yourself if you think that you didn't do well. I swear, I know you did. And math, to be honest, it's not just a matter of being good. Academically, parang meron ding luck na involved. PR kasi yung pagbabasehan. Since PR score nga yung usapan, super big thing kung sino yung mga makakasabay mo, yung mga questions na mapapatapat sa'yo, sa set or sa day nyo. Nakaka-anxious talaga yung NMAT. Pag natapos nyo na siya, kapag na-submit nyo na din, sobrang laki na nung tinik na matatanggal. Go on with your life now once you are done. And pat yourself on the back kasi na-survive nyo siya. One thing that I did right after the NMAT is I avoid discussing it among my peers kasi sobrang nakaka-anxious. Tapos, nag-leave na ako sa mga group chats, ganyan. Kasi I don't want myself to be reminded na with NMAT anymore. It's finally done and na-survive ko na siya. So, it's done. So, yeah, the last thing na kailangan na lang natin gawin is to just to pray, and wait for the result. Kasi, ayun nga, very multifaceted yung NMAT. Whatever the result will be, congratulate yourself for succeeding, for doing your best. Yeah, lastly, never compare your score with those of other people, okay? So, just focus and just celebrate what you have on your own because that's the best thing to do. Once you do that, it will go a really, really long way na. Just be proud of yourself. I know that you did your best and I know that you did great. So, yeah. Thank you so much for reaching this part of the video. I hope na nakapag-share ako ng mga helpful na bagay na makakatulong sa inyo sa pag-prepare nyo for NMAT. I really wish you the best. I am praying for you guys. I hope that you will get the peer score that you want. And yeah, I hope that I'll see you in the medical field.